Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining me on this episode of JM Plays Badly. On today's episode, we are playing Star Wars The Old Republic. We are back on our Bounty Hunter. And in our last video, I was debating if I wanted to go straight to Dromand Kass or if I wanted to do the Flashpoint, the Black Talon. I decided I want to do the Black Talon, mostly for the experience, but also for the potential of getting some better gear. So we're going to try to queue up for that. I think you get two options. You can either do these solo, or you can do them in what they call a veteran group, which just means that there's no specific role that anybody has to fill. You know, you could actually do this with a party of tanks, a party of DPS, a party of healers, any combination. So we're going to talk to the Black Talon valet, and we're going to see if we can get into it.
Mem ama kupka kramanik umnu giga mayamak. Nulak apajam kamgam. Amka nem nang. Ampa nem nang memua inok. Raka kalam kala. Nimyak oramag yang megik.
Let's make this happen.
Nanekari maraka amkam. Ja uklibik. Memarak nebab. Ja kipem guana.
Yeah, so the see, you start story mode, which I believe is solo. Veteran mode is the one I think we want. We have to... Yeah. There we go. We have to actively join the queue for it. I don't know how long it's going to take, so we're just going to kind of... I'll trim the video between here and when we actually get into the Flashpoint.
Tell the captain that I'll be back on the bridge as soon as I've done his errand.
Yes, sir.
Good to have you aboard. I'm Lieutenant Silas, second in command of the Black Talon. We're your ride to Dromand Kass.
A pleasure to meet you.
Indeed. Welcome. It's not a comfortable ship, but as transports go, it does its job. On our present course, we should arrive at the capital within a day. Won't be any trouble. In the meantime, your droid's in the conference room. We picked it up with the upgrades from Geonosis. When we docked here, it mentioned your names.
Sorry. I don't know what droid you're talking about.
Oh? The machine asked for you, so I assumed you were the owner. My mistake. In any case, it seems someone wants to get in touch. The conference room is down the hall. I'll be on the bridge. And you, soldier, when you're done playing honor guard, get back to your post. This isn't a luxury yacht.
Yes, sir.
All right. I also didn't notice that I actually had my mic muted at one point, so... Somebody else a leader. I don't want to be a leader.
Identity confirmed. Good day. I'm Advanced Protocol Unit NRO2. My functions are diplomacy, translation, manslaughter, and calumniation. I have an urgent message for you from my master. Please stand by for delivery.
Who's your master, and how does he know I'm here?
This is Unit NRO2 to Grand Moff Kilrin. You are now in contact with the Black Talon.
Well, so I am, and it seems you've brought me just the people I've been looking for. My name is Rikus Kilrin. I'm commander of the 5th Fleet, second to the Minister of War, and my personal favorite, the so-called Butcher of Coruscant.
Something wrong with a hologram, or is your face supposed to look like that?
The scars. They're an old gift from a Jedi friend. I barely notice them anymore. 6 hours ago, the Republic engaged in an illegal border skirmish on the edges of Imperial territory. One enemy warship escaped. That warship, the Brentel Star, is carrying a passenger of vital strategic importance. Yours is the only vessel placed to intercept.
This passenger the Brentel Star is carrying, who is it?
The warship's passenger is codenamed the General. We don't know his identity, but the Republic believes he possesses military secrets, our military secrets. I trust the reports. The General must be captured or killed. Captain Orzik, the man commanding your transport, doesn't share my enthusiasm. He's disobeyed my orders to attack. Feel free to show him what the Empire does to cowards. Then commandeer his ship, find the Brentel Star, and deal with the General.
Not exactly a simple request, you know.
This is not a simple age. Our millennia-old war against the Republic simmers while we engage in skirmishes and border disputes. Yet we cannot grow complacent. Traitors like your captain and threats like the General must be eliminated.
I will lead the way to the bridge. Once Captain Orzik is deposed and our hijacking is complete, we may proceed to the Brentel Star. Excellent. Then I will proceed.
Halt! This is a restricted area. Captain Orzik's command. You'll have to leave immediately.
I suggest you back off before someone gets hurt.
I'm afraid I can't do that. This is the command deck entry hatch. No one's allowed in until we reach our destination.
Time is limited. We must proceed to the bridge immediately.
Our orders were to treat any approach as an attack. You need to take your droid and move it.
No talking. It's time to die.
Blasters out! Attack! Attack!
You must proceed to the bridge immediately. Concerned about the loss of life, I assure you, the deaths of all injured crew members will be strategically insignificant.
So far, we're just kind of rushing through, which is cool. It looks like this is one of those groups that does this often, so they know a couple of shortcuts.
Marines have been neutralized, scanning for additional threats.
What's going on? Sir, stay calm, Ensign. Everyone stay calm.
No threats found. The bridge is now secure.
Who Who's calling the shots here?
I'm Captain Revenant Orzik. I'm pretty sure I know what this is about. For the record, I take complete responsibility for my actions.
Captain Orzik, I'm told you disobeyed a direct order from Grand Moff Kilran.
Yes, I had no idea he'd respond this brutally. He must want the Brental Star's passenger pretty badly. Maybe he just hates me. The Black Talon would be destroyed chasing a battleship. I've fought in the war before and I'll fight again, but I don't do suicide missions.
Well, let's see, do I want to do light side or dark side? I have a feeling... I'm gonna do light side on this one.
I'm not looking to make a martyr of anyone. We can complete this mission and survive.
I expect you believe that. I see it differently. Listen to me. You've managed to hijack one ship, and that's certainly impressive. But taking on the Brental Star is something else altogether. I might be able to get us close, but then you'd have to board it, fight an army of Republic soldiers, and somehow find a general. It's unacceptable.
We don't have a choice. Those were Moff Kilran's instructions. So if we're gonna survive, we need to work together.
I see. You're as much a victim here as I am, aren't you? Damn Kilran and his fleet. All right. I'm not ready to be branded a traitor just yet. We'll get the general. I'm not sure how, but we'll get him.
I like the story. I don't, you know, I'm sure some people want to move on and don't want to take the time, but...
I'll handle it.
I'll do my best to remember that.
Downloading new orders to all bridge consoles. Priority 1, intercept the Brental Star.
You heard the droid, everyone. Prepare to jump to light speed.
It's a fair-sized ship.
Emerging from hyperspace now. One Thranta-class warship on the scanners. Powering up...
is firing. Turbo lasers, missiles, and what looks like transport pods. I'm not sure.
Evasive maneuvers. Keep the pods at distance. They look harmless, but they'll latch onto the hull and cut at us with sabotage droids.
Evasive maneuvers. Aye, sir.
Sir, three shuttles on an intercept course.
An assault party. We don't have sufficient defenses to keep them from landing.
What do you suggest we do?
Once those vessels make it to the shuttle bay, Republic troops will swarm the Black Talon.
Imperial security forces may be insufficient to contain the enemy boarding party.
The droid's right. Once we're engaged in corridor-to-corridor fighting, we'll never get back on the offensive. If you can get to the shuttle bay and deal with the Republic troops, we can handle things up here. Otherwise, I don't know what happens.
I think we lost another one of our players, so I'm gonna see if I can summon Mako here.
Getting lonely?
Secondary power systems damaged. Non-essential systems may be inoperable. Oh, jeez. He went ahead of me and got into combat.
On the way.
guys out. It looks like it's down to just me and this other guy. I think the third person either disconnected or got fed up with it. It must be nice to be an Imperial agent and be able to just sneak in.
You never should have attacked us!
Oh, probably not, but you know what? It didn't stop us, did it?
You never should have attacked us! Imperial arrogance knows no bounds.
So they say.
This is the captain. If you can hear this, we need you on the bridge.
Nice. Oh, darn it. Something else that, like, completely disappeared were my, some of my abilities. And I have no idea where they went. I don't know where my, I have to be around the mount anyway. Okay, back to the bridge.
Damage reports from all decks. We're holding together, sir, but I don't know for how long.
Make it last, Ensign. Don't let us down.
Please stand alert. Grand Moff Kilran's representatives have returned.
I see you took care of the Republic assault. Welcome back to the bridge.
Thank you, Captain.
We've survived the first wave of attacks on the Rental Star. Things will be calm until we enter fighter range. Another minute, maybe two.
Transmission coming in. Long range. It's a message, but it's not from the Rental Star.
How can that be?
The Rental Star must have sent a distress signal. Someone's responding.
Okay. Oh.
This is Jedi Grandmaster Satil Shan hailing unidentified Imperial vessel. I'm en route to your location with 16 Republic vessels. I'm asking you to retreat before more lives are lost.
A pleasure to meet you.
I'm glad to hear a voice of reason. Let us end this conflict together. The Brenthal Star is under my protection. Our convoy was ambushed and I sent the Star ahead. We will reunite. I just crippled 3 Imperial Dreadnoughts. I don't wish to destroy you. The peace between Republic and Empire is fragile enough already.
Tell the Brenthal Star to hand over the General. No one needs to be hurt.
The General has a role to play with the Republic. Incidents like this are happening across the galaxy, but only because we let them. Leave the Brenthal Star to me. If you don't, then may the Force be with you. Because the men and women aboard that ship can hold you off until we arrive. And you will be defeated.
You're deluding yourself. The ship is already mine.
You've made yourself clear. But I suggest you prepare to face a Jedi. And you may want to consider what that means.
Entering fighter range. The Brenthal Star is launching its first squadron.
It's time for us to do the same. I assume you'll be leading the boarding party to go after the General.
Whatever's necessary to finish this.
There's one other thing. I promised you my help, so I brought you some supplies from the cargo bay. Someone on Dromand Kass may be disappointed when they don't receive the delivery, but I thought our situation took precedence.
Yes.
I gotta say, I'm impressed.
Thank you. We're all doing our best here.
I advise that you proceed to the shuttle bay. The flight to the Brenthal Star may be hazardous. But Grand Moff Kilran has complete faith in your abilities.
All right. Next up. Next up, the hangar bay. We're actually moving right along. I think that's because my other, my only other party member now, is like also good at this, you know. One thing you can do is you can use the space bar to skip cutscenes and stuff. The only reason I'm not doing that is because I like the the story. Oh, I'm taking a minute to load in. Oh, there we go. I don't mind skipping things. It's kind of refreshing. Just gotta stay behind the guy and, you know, let him lead. It was like somehow this group came out of nowhere. Done loaded my rockets, I guess. There we go. Droids do anything fighting us. That's handy. What's funny is that there's a bonus mission to defeat, like, 25 Republic forces, and we're, almost there already. Oh look, and we leveled up.
This is Protocol Unit NRO2. I hope you're receiving this message clearly, and that your flight was free of incident. Please hold for Security Coordinator Ensign Brukhara.
The Marines are on their way. They'll follow you in and hold each junction you secure. Try not to take too long. We're not a military ship. What you have is all you're getting.
I appreciate the warning.
I have been scanning the Brentol Star's communications, and security forces appear to be moving to protect the escape pods. It is extremely likely that the crew is attempting to evacuate the general. You must retrieve or eliminate him before he escapes.
I don't need a droid telling me how to do things.
Understood. I am simply looking after Grand Moff Killorin's interests.
That was pretty good.
I will be in contact if the situation changes. Proceed to assault all defense points between you and the target.
Okay. was good. We managed to sneak by that one. Oh, I guess he decided we weren't going to be able to sneak by this one. Want to do when I'm done with this. I don't know if I'll do it as part of the video, a separate video, or even just off camera. I want to add a second combat specialization, or combat style.
You're speaking to a Special Forces commander, Meat. Show some respect.
Yep, I like this guy. Commander Gully, or whatever his name is.
So, you think you're tough meat? Part of me was hoping you'd try to board this ship.
Yeah. He's a Republic War veteran. He's a Mon Calamari, and he refers to us as meat. It's kind of funny. Kind of funny to listen to.
Star! Attack! For the Republic!
There we go. All right. What'd I get? Oh, nice. That was pretty good. We're almost at the escape pods. I think we're getting close to the boss, the final boss of the Flashpoint. I should learn to use my keys more than my whatchamacallit, but. His ability to cloak himself is definitely a blessing. I'll get the three by the door with my death from above. I think what's funny is that his companion actually spends more time hanging out by me than by him. That's actually funny. I had more, I just wish the cooldown on Death from Above was a little shorter. It makes it hard to, control groups of enemies that way. Oh. Oh, this must be the final boss. Okay.
Oh. Escape pods aren't far now. You can make it on your own, General.
And what about you?
Oh,
I will face my destiny. Go now, my friend. Halt where you are. I am Yadira Ban, Padawan of the Jedi Order. I was sent to protect the General, and you will not pass.
Surrender. Give me what I want and your ship can survive.
I cannot accept that. A Jedi does not surrender the innocent into the hands of evil. But I intend to drive you back, meter by meter if need be, just as the Republic pushed the Sith Empire into the dark of the galaxy.
In case you hadn't noticed, the Empire is back, and we'll destroy you.
You cannot destroy us. No more than a shadow can destroy he who casts it. You may run, or you may stand your ground, but you'll go no farther. You aren't going to win this. I swear it.
Okay, then. I was in the middle of my attack, and she actually pulled me out of it. Of course. Okay, then. I was going to provide some off-heal, but I think Mako is doing that just fine.
You aren't going to win this. I swear it.
Yeah, you keep saying that, and someday even you'll believe it.
You aren't going to win this. I swear it.
We almost got her. Almost got her, barely taking any damage. There we go. What'd I get? Something else good? I did, actually. I got some armor that's good. It's like, oh, you defeated the last boss of the instance. Well, there's still a couple more challenges to get through, so... It's like, gee, thanks. Wow, we gained two levels in here, actually.
You're gonna get it now.
Got a bunch of cool stuff. Tracer missiles. I got my heroic moment and energy shield. Alright.
You can put aside your weapons. I won't try to run. Besides, I doubt I'd make it to an escape pod without my intestines spilling out.
How did you get injured?
Unlucky. Caught in your ship's attack. I'm told the wounds aren't fatal, but that doesn't help the pain. I was a general in the Imperial Military Service. Did they tell you that when they sent you here? Did they even know?
Why would you betray the Empire?
If you knew what I knew, you'd understand. If you'd heard what both sides are plotting, you wouldn't be eager to restart this war. They're building doomsday weapons, shields that envelop planets, missiles that darken suns.
Ooh.
Republic and Empire are planning to raise worlds, annihilate civilizations. It will be unlike anything the galaxy's seen since the Great Hyperspace War. And it's too late to stop it. The so-called peace is already lost.
If that's true, why defect to the Republic?
There's no place for me in the Empire anymore. I thought my last act might be to even the odds, create a stalemate. It doesn't seem to matter anymore. Oh, you have me then? Me, my stomach full of blood, and my implant full of cybernetic secrets and stolen plans. What will you do?
I'm gonna leave him alive.
I'm going to bring you to my ship, From there, you'll be transported to Dromand Kass and taken into Imperial custody.
Where I'll be tortured or executed, or at best, placed in a cell for the rest of my life. Still, there's nowhere in the galaxy where I could truly hide. I will follow you.
One thing I do like is they build all of the instances so that, like, 90% of the time, your exit is very close to the entrance. You can actually, you know, you can't cheat and go the back way to get to any of these places, but you can at least go to where you need to go. Gotta remember to thank this guy for the group, too.
Captain Orzik here. I understand you're on your way back. I assume congratulations are in order. Our Marines have been recalled to the Black Talon. As soon as you're aboard, we'll jump to light speed. Republic reinforcements could arrive at any minute.
Prepare a holding cell. I'm bringing a prisoner.
The General? I'm sure the droid and Grand Moff Kilrun would be pleased to have him arrive. I'll see you on the bridge. Congratulations again. Orzik out.
This is actually a fun flashpoint. I do like how the game won't let you not participate in conversations too.
Well,
in the flashpoints.
The heroes of the day return. Welcome back, sir. My men will take the General to the brig. Congratulations. I never expected the mission to go off this cleanly.
I'm glad to see you're so happy.
What's not to be pleased about? You spared my life, and we eliminated an enemy of the Empire.
Grand Moff Kilrun is eagerly awaiting your report. Should I put him through?
It's your command again. Make the call.
Put the Grand Moff through.
Opening channel now.
Well, how fortunate I could reach my friends aboard the Black Talon. The droid's been keeping me appraised of your work, but I very much wanted to hear from you. How did the attack go?
You know what?
The Brentar Star has been disabled and the General captured.
Okay.
He'll be in your hands soon.
Excellent. I'll let Korriban and Imperial Intelligence fight over him. You should be proud. This is only one of the many operations we're conducting across the galaxy. It's a new beginning to the war. The General was one of the greatest weapons the Republic had. A defector. And you've snatched him from enemy hands. I'll remember this. And I'll make sure you're rewarded.
Remember my name. Spread it around.
I'll make sure your heroism is mentioned when I report to the other Moffs. But my words hardly matter. Soon you'll be joining us on the homeworld, and you can see for yourself what you've been fighting for. It should be inspiring. Enjoy the rest of your journey. Kilrun out.
All right, then. And we're going to take the ship to the rest of the way to Dromand Kass. I wonder if it's a choice thing, or... He's probably letting me decide, because, He's a good sport about it, too. I apologize for making him sit through all the cutscenes. He said it's all good. was pretty good. Okay. And we got a lot of experience. We got some late side points. I got a lot of influence with Mako. And I got 318 credits. Plus, I did a group finder mission, so I also got some bonus experience there. So, we actually did really good. We gained 2 levels, and we got some better gear. Let's just, let me real quick go into my inventory. I want to see what I got. So, I've got an implant, which is better. I got a new ear equipment. And I got new armor. Do I have a... I think I have a an appearance customization. No, I don't. It's just the armor looks like the armor is the exact same. That's all. That's all right though. Keeps things easy. I also got all these backpacks. They're satchels of crafting materials. So. Alright. Not bad at all. I also got supercharged gas. Oh, nice. Okay. Requires and converts 10 stacks of supercharge to vent 10 heat and increase armor penetration by 15% for 8 seconds. Let's see. I don't know how you earn it, but I'm sure it's got something to do with some other stuff. I also got rail shot, which is good. Usable against incapacitated targets or targets suffering from periodic damage, so that's always handy. And then this energy shield, which reduces damage by 25% for 12 seconds, so I got some good stuff. I'll rearrange my hotbar later. And then my one thing became a tracer missile. My, which I don't understand, my aim shot became a tracer missile now. So, you know, my power shot was replaced. I don't know why. I like power shot, but that's alright. Tracer missile's fine. I am not in a rest area, so we're gonna go find a rest area quick. I think the shuttle port itself is one. I guess the only mount I can use right now. That's why it's the only one, because I'm using random mount, and this is the only one that's coming up. Oh, I gotta stop it. Apparently I have to stop at customs on my way in. Alright, we're gonna do that first. Then...
Ugh, spaceports all smell the same. Engine exhaust, coolant fluid, and spacers who haven't bathed in a week. Let's get out of this stink. Whatever the rest of Dromand Kass is like, the air has got to be fresher than in here.
I would have figured you'd been to Dromand Kass before.
Brayden and I moved around a lot when we first got together, but we never made it here. Keep in mind, Imperials aren't fond of aliens. Step out of line, and they'll notice. If we tweak the local authorities, they can make life really hard.
Yeah.
I like tweaking with authority.
How did I know you were gonna say that? Come on, the Mandalorian Enclave is in the Citadel. Our contact is someone named Chris DeMarcon.
Okay. And Chris DeMarcon that she mentioned is, her name was actually mentioned when we took on the Black Talon. The alien that, gave us the mission mentioned that we had our, entry fee paid by them. So let me see. I don't know if there's actually a cantina in the spaceport. I don't know if the spaceport is a rest area or not. Usually buildings are. Starship upgrades. We're just gonna take a look around. If this gets old, I'll just cut some of this stuff out of the video.
Jeez, it's so dark. Let's see what time it is here. Oh, apparently it's always this gloomy. Lovely.
Yeah, it is kind of dark and gloomy, but it's cool looking for a jungle planet. Oh, here's our daily heroic mission, terminal, medical supplies, stuff like that. There's a... I think we already know about it. I don't think we have to unlock them anymore, but I will anyway, just in case. So we can use... which has also disappeared. A lot of my stuff disappeared recently. I think they did an update, and when they did, they changed a bunch of stuff. There's actually a quest inside, and I think since we're going to the main city, it's actually a good one to pick up.
You, bounty hunter. I require your services. Are you for hire? At this moment, Lord Kras is meeting with the Minister of War to make recommendations for our next moves against the Republic. I've prepared his reports, but he also desires a personal interview with someone involved in the recent fighting.
Tell me where to find your lord, and I'll be on my way.
He's in the Citadel. Please proceed in a timely fashion. And remember to show Lord Kras, and any other Sith you meet, the proper level of respect.
That's right, because it's the Sith Empire. Yeah, non-Sith are not well-liked. Alright, so it didn't say you have entered or left a rest zone when I went in there, so we're going to take the speeder.
Destination?
And... I love how they're all open. So, we're actually going to go to Kass City Central.
Enjoy your stay.
Because I want to find a... I want to find a cantina. This is the other reason to take this. I mean, you can walk all the way to Dromand Kass if you want, but there are, like, a lot of monsters along the road that lead there. You know, the speeder is actually, you know, not only is it faster, obviously, but it's considerably safer. Not to mention, I think as you adventure on Dromand Kass, you actually have to end up coming to a lot of these places anyway, so... You'll actually come and visit them all throughout your class quest story. Which, you know, I'm going to stick to something. Yeah, see, there you go. I've discovered the Nexus Room Cantina. It's here somewhere. I just don't know where. I'll have to find it. A lot of quests around. Thought it could not. It might not be. All right. Let me see if I can. Over here. Okay. So apparently I'm looking right at it now when the map's off. Okay. So it's over here somewhere. I just have to figure out how to get into it. So once I get into the cantina. Cantinas are rest areas. You know. I think we mentioned this before. And once I'm in a rest area, unless this is a rest area. There
we go.
Wow,
this place looks lively. I guess the Imperials have something that passes for fun after all.
All right. There you go. And then, of course, you know, there's other things, too, there's other vendors all over the place.
I've got the best hardware and the best prices.
You know, you can get, this is kind of cool. These are kind of cool, these, Imperial targeting devices. It basically almost like games that have, like, Hunter's Mark on a hunter, you know? And then you can get, you know, these are for, female characters, you can get an elegant dress. Male characters get formal jackets. Yeah, you can get a bunch of stuff.
Good hunting.
It's mostly social items. You can use them as costumes. There's a band over here. It's all robots. You know, you buy cantina tokens, you can do that.
Elegant slave stock.
Aren't they? Imported direct from Ryloth. Lostrani branded. I suffer only the best help.
But those are Darth Thanaton's exclusive staples.
He'll have you executed.
I had no idea.
Present them as a gift in Darth Thanaton's honor. It's your only hope.
Brilliant. Thank goodness they don't speak basic.
Cool, Barana?
Shut up, slave.
Oh, yeah, that's the other problem with the Empire. The Empire is real big on slaves. Well, anyway, and Mako doesn't have enough affection to want to talk. So, all right. Well, anyway, that about does it for today's episode. If this is your first time here, don't forget to hit those like, subscribe, and notification buttons so you can stay up to date on everything we're working on. You can also support the channel on Patreon. There is a link to that in the description below. There is also a link to my Twitch channel so you can be notified when I'm streaming. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next episode.